But there is no use talking about it.
Why not?
Why should I get rid of her?
Well, you have a few more without her.
I see. Today you want one, tomorrow you will want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
The same as you do with one.
Look, Debbie, this is very important to me.
Why is it important to you?
Well, frankly, because I'm lonely.
Lonely? What are you talking about?
You don't know.
We're talking about my new milk cow, the one you want to buy from me.
A milk cow, so I won't be lonely.
What's so funny?
I am talking about your daughter, Zeitel.
Daughter Zeitel?
Yes. I see her every Thursday in my butcher shop. She has made a good impression on me. I like her. As you know, Debbie, I'm pretty well off. I have my own house, a good shop, servants. Look, Debbie, let's shake on it and call it a match. And you won't need a dowry. I like her, Debbie. I will be good to her. What do you think?
What do I think? I never really liked him. Why should I? You can have a fine conversation with him if you talk about kidneys and livers. On the other hand, not everybody has to be a scholar. And if you're wealthy enough, no one will call you stupid. And with a butcher, surely my daughter will never know hunger. He likes her. He will try to make her happy. What do I think? It's a match.
Oh, Tevye, that's wonderful. Let's drink on it.
Why not? To you.
Oh, no, my friend. To you.
To the both of us.
To our agreement.
To our agreement. To our good health and happiness. And most important of all,
to life, l'chaim. L'chaim, l'chaim, to life. Dear to the Father, I pray to be. Dear to my bride to be. Drink l'chaim, to life, l'chaim. L'chaim, l'chaim, to life. Life has a way of confusing us, testing and bruising us. Drink l'chaim, to life. God would like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lie patting on the floor. How much more can we be joyful when there's really something to be joyful for?
To life, l'chaim.
To Zeitel, my daughter,
my wife.
It gives you something to drink about, something to drink about. Drink l'chaim, to life.
Reporter!
Yes, sir.
A drink for everybody.
What's the occasion?
I am taking myself a bride.
Who is this?
I'm Debbie's eldest, Zeitel.
To Zeitel, my daughter,
my wife.
May all our futures be pleasant ones, not like our present ones. Drink l'chaim, to life, l'chaim. L'chaim, l'chaim, to life. It takes a wedding to make us say, let's live another day. Drink l'chaim, to life. Die, 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 die.
Heaven bless you, both Nazdrovia, to your
After the marriage, you and I will be related. You will be my papa.
Your papa? I always wanted a son, but I wanted one a little younger than myself.
Xavier, I have a piece of news that I think I should tell you. As a friend.
Yeah. Yes, Your Honor.
And I'm giving you this news because I like you. You're a decent, honest man, even though you're a Jewish dog.
Thank you, Your Honor. How often does a man get a compliment like that? And the news?
We've just received orders that sometime soon, this district is to have a little unofficial demonstration.
How little?
Not too serious, just some mischief so that if an inspector were to come by, he can see that we've done our duty. Although personally, I don't know why there must be this trouble between people, but I thought I should tell you, so you can tell the others.
Thank you, Your Honor. You're a good man. If I may say so, it's too bad you're not a Jew.
That's what I like about you, Tevye. Always joking. And, oh! Congratulations on your daughter.
Thank you, Your Honor. Goodbye. Did you have to send news like that today, of all days? It's true we are the chosen people, but once in a while can't you choose someone else? Anyway, thanks for sending a husband for my Zeitel. L'chaim.
Children, I will tell you a story from the Bible of Laban and Jacob. Now, Laban had two daughters, Leah and beautiful Rachel. And Jacob loved the younger, Rachel, and he asked Laban for her hand. Laban agreed if Jacob would work for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
Of course, he was an employer. Now, after Jacob worked 7 years, Laban fooled him and gave him his ugly daughter, Leah. So to marry Rachel, Jacob was forced to work another 7 years. You see, children, the Bible clearly teaches us you must never trust an employer. Do you understand? Good. I'll teach you another story. Here.
Papa isn't up yet?
No, Mama.
Then enough lessons. We have Papa's work to do today. He staggered home last night and I couldn't get a word out of him. Put that away and clean the barn. And call me when Papa gets up.
That was a very interesting lesson, Virtue.
Do you think so?
Although I don't know if the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
And neither, I suppose, would the rabbi's son.
So what do you know about him anyway? Except that he's the rabbi's son. Would you be interested in him if he were the shoemaker's son or the tinsmith's son?
At least I know. He does not have any strange ideas about turning the world upside down.
Certainly. Any strange idea would be new to you. Remember, the Lord said, let there be light.
Yes. But he was not talking to you personally.
You have spirit, even a little intelligence, perhaps.
We have an old custom here. A boy acts respectfully to a girl. But of course, that is too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Our tradition. Our ways are changing everywhere, but here. Here, men study, women in the kitchen. Boys and girls mustn't touch, shouldn't even look at each other.
I'm looking at you.
You're very brave.
Do you know that in the city, boys and girls can be affectionate without the permission of a matchmaker? They can hold hands together. They can dance together. New dances like this. You like it? I learnt it in Kiev.
It's very nice.
There, we just changed an old custom.
Yes, you're welcome. Thank you. Good day.
Good day.
Bielka Sprinzer. What's your name?
Hordle, Papa.
Ah, Hordle. Paul Zeitel. Perchik, how did the lesson go?
I think we made a good beginning.
Ah, you're finally up. What happened last night besides you drinking like a peasant? Did you meet Laser Wolf? What did he say? What did you say? Oh, do you have any news?
Patience, woman. As the good book says, good news will stay and bad news will refuse to leave. There is another saying.
Oh, that... you can die from such a man.
Ah, Zeitel, Zeitel, my lamb. Come here, Zeitel. You are to be congratulated. You are going to be married.
Oh, married.
What do you mean, Papa?
Laser Wolf has asked for your hand.
But you... Oh, my heart told me that this was going to be a lucky day. Oh, God, I thank thee. I thank thee. Oh.
And what do you say, Zeitel?
Oh, what can she say? My firstborn a bride. May you grow old with him, not like Frumacera, his first wife. She was a bitter woman. And now, I must go and thank Yenta. 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 Yenta.
No, oh, Yenta.
And you, Perchik, aren't you going to congratulate her?
Congratulations, Zeitel, for getting a rich man.
Again with the rich? What's wrong with being rich?
It is no reason to marry. Money is the world's curse.
May the Lord smite me with it. And may I never recover. Zeitel knows I mean only her welfare. Am I right, Zeitel? Well, why are you so silent, Zeitel? Aren't you happy with this blessing?
Oh, Papa, Papa!
What? What is it?
Papa, I don't want to marry him. I can't marry him.
What do you mean you can't? If I say you will, you will.
Papa, if it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll hire myself out as a servant. I'll dig ditches. I'll haul rocks. Only don't make me marry him, Papa, please.
But what's wrong with Laser? He likes you.
I'll be unhappy with him.
But we made an agreement.
Is that more important than I am, Papa? Papa, please don't force me. I'll be unhappy all my days.
All right. I won't force you.
Thank you.
It seems it was not ordained that you should have all the comforts in life. Or that we should have a little joy in our old age after all our hard work.
Reptavia! 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 May I speak with you?
Not now, mortal. I have problems.
That's what I want to speak to you about. I think I can help.
Certainly. Like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, mortal.
At least listen to him, Papa.
Reptavia.
All right. You have a tongue. Talk.
I hear you're arranging a match for Zeitel.
He also has ears.
I have a match for Zeitel.
What kind of match?
A perfect fit.
A perfect fit.
Like a glove.
Like a glove.
This match was made exactly to measurement.
A perfect fit, made to measure. Stop talking like a tailor and tell me, who is it?
Please, please. Don't shout at me.
All right. Who is it?
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 It's me! Myself.
Him? Himself? Either you're completely out of your mind or you're crazy. Arranging a match for yourself, what are you? The bridegroom, the matchmaker, the guests all rolled into one? I suppose you'll even perform the ceremony yourself.
Times are changing, Reptevia. The thing is, your daughter and Zeitel and I gave each other a pledge over a year ago that we would marry.
You gave each other a pledge?
Yes, sir.
We gave each other a pledge. Unheard of, absurd! Where do you think you are? America? What do you think you're doing? You a stitcher, you are nothing! This isn't the way it's done. Marriages must be arranged by the papa. This should never be changed. One little time I pull out a prop, and where does it stop? Where does it stop? Do I still have something to say about my daughter? Or doesn't anyone have to ask a father anymore?
I've been wanting to ask you for some time, Reptevia. But first I wanted to save up for my own sewing machine.
Stop talking nonsense. You're just a poor tailor.
That's true, Reptevia, but even a poor tailor's entitled to some happiness. I promise you, Reptevia,